In the last video, we developed a model for this simple current boosting circuit for linear regulators such as the 78XX family. We found that there exists an output current value I tilde equal to the base emitter junction drop divided by the resistor RB, after which the transistor starts to conduct. The regulator will continue to provide a current ID equal to I tilde plus a small load-dependent contribute dampened by the beta of the transistor, while the transistor takes all the remaining current. Today we'll make a practical example, choosing the right components values and building the real circuit so that we can take some measurements and check whether our theory applies or if it is useless. We'll design a 24V regulator with a maximum current of 1A. I know this looks slow, but since I'm gonna build this on a breadboard, I'd like to avoid melting it. Nevertheless, everything perfectly applies for higher currents, just change the numbers in the calculations. We want our transistor to kick in before 150 mA. In this way, we can compute the minimum resistor value, which is 4 ohm. We'll choose the next commercial value, which is 4.7 ohm, that gives us an I tilde value of 125 mA. What power rating shall we choose? The power dissipated on the resistor can be easily obtained from Ohm's law, which gives us 4.7 watts dissipated at the maximum current. The best choice for a continuous load would then be a 10 watts resistor. We can also compute the power dissipated on the transistor in the same way. I've considered the minimum input voltage for a 7824, which is 33 volts, so an heat sink might be useful. For those who are still with me after this little math, we can start building the circuit. We need a 7824 and a suitable transistor. I've chosen a BD438 bipolar, which is actually a mid-power transistor only because power transistors like the more famous 2N2955 usually come in a TO3 package, which is quite an hassle to work with on a breadboard. And finally our resistor. Don't forget the usual filtering capacitors on the input and the output terminals of the regulator, and let's finally add our transistor. We now need a way to test our circuit. A resistor on the output might work, however, to test different output current values, we'd need lots of them. Luckily, there's a cheaper alternative. With just a MOSFET, another resistor, and an operational amplifier, you can build yourself a simple active load. Without losing too much time, you can prove by yourself that the current synced from the drain terminal will be equal to the voltage of the non-inverting input of the op-amp divided by the resistor on the source side. This way, with just a potentiometer, we can easily change the load current of our regulator. The idea is then simple, we'll sweep enough load current and measure the total current and the current coming from the collector, which will give us the current coming from the regulator as well. And I'll spare you all the boring measurements. Before looking at the result, we need to give a look at what we should be expecting. Let's consider the typical beta value for this transistor, which is 140, and plot the equation we've seen at the beginning. And here's our model. We expect the regulator to provide all the output current until I tilde, then it sort of stabilizes and the transistor will provide the rest of it. There's actually a small increment in the regulator current as well, but since it is divided by the beta of the transistor, it is almost impossible to see on this graph. And now let's add the measurements. The results follow quite precisely what we expected, besides some minor variation. It is quite interesting to note the behavior at high currents. There seems to be a quite sudden decrease of the transistor current and an increase of the regulator current. Let's give a look at the transistor datasheet once again. And here's the explanation. The transistor's beta decreases with high collector current. This is due to the device physics itself, and there's nothing much we can really do about it. So, when designing your own current-boosted linear regulator, give yourself quite a good margin when setting the transistor trigger current, and be sure to provide good power dissipation to both the regulator and the power transistor. Last thing, what if you don't have a power PNP transistor, but just NPNs? Well, there is a solution, but you need to build a completely different circuit. Let me know in the comments if you'd like a dedicated video about it.